Authority by Marins Castleblaney, number one for Toyota in the Northeast since 1976, and changing the game in 2019 with the new range of hybrids built for a better world.
GA News First at 6 o'clock with one of your historic AIB All Ireland Club campaign came to an end with 18 points to 2-7 in the semi-final defeat to Dr. Brooks in purpose of Saturday. Mullignata manager Mickey Graham stepped down from the role to fully focus on managing the Castle senior team. He remarks that he loved his 3 years with the club.
Had three great years, just a bunch of lads. When I first arrived, you know, these boys were knocking on the door, looking to win the county championship. And when I came first, I couldn't believe the talent that I've seen at first hand. And it was great just to see them lads for reaching their pace and their full potential and to get to this stage, you know. And I'm very proud of them. I couldn't be prouder of the lads for every single one of them. They've been a pleasure to work with, and there are a bunch of players that I know that will, you know, not drop their heads. They'll be disappointed on the day, but they'll come back and struggle for hopefully
Dr. Crokes will face defending champions Cora Finn in the final on St. Patrick's Day. The Galway side beat Gweedore in their semi-final 2-13-1-12. In Hurling, Mullin got their first win of their Alliance League Division 3A campaign with a 4-12-2-13 win over Tyrone. Barney manager Trevor Hilliard recalls his Castleblaney players after missing the opening two rounds through club commitments. Sides were level with 10 minutes remaining. Gall Power put the visitors ahead in injury time with Stephen Lamb's goal sealing the victory. Cavan meanwhile fell to a 4-19-2-6 defeat to tabletopper Sligo with their second match in Division 3B. Hubert Odie got four goals for Cavan while Keaton Raymond got a hat-trick for Sligo. Kevin Gilmer got a goal for Kevin Keneally was sent off for Cavan in the second half. Sligo were 18 points ahead at half-time, and Cavan manager Michael Carr says all the damage was done in the first half.
But this is a tough deal. Started against the great first half, which things didn't go right for the first half at all. We just got tackles everywhere. 1-15, we were sort of in the race for the first half at all. The lads just took the foot off the bread and put it the break. I hope that we have turned on the second half, but we get the leg away too far. The first half, half-time, we said just go. We start all over again and see how we get on. We knew it was really to come up back to bed, but when I got sent off then, we just had really sensitive scores. That was worse than I got then.
Ladies football, Mullaghorn won the Corvus Town Paddy O'Shea Ladies Football Tournament, beating Thomas Davis 3-13-1-6 in yesterday's final. Rugby and Stuart McCloskey marked his 100th appearance for Ulster with a try in their 8-0 victory at Ospreys in the Pro 14. The victory lifts Dan McFarlane's side to third place in Conference B, having booked their place in the North West Cup semi-final with a 35-28 win over Strabane. In boxing, Monaghan's Dermot Duffy qualified for the 57-kilogram final in the National Boxing Championships with a win over St. Anthony's fighter Mary Geraghty.
birthday today. A very, very happy birthday to